GoForTheTwo.com in with the Week 12 predictions. Before I give you the selections for this coming Saturday, college football today, this weekend, Saturday, November 16th, live from the Sports Grid studio inside the FanDuel Sportsbook at the Meadowlands. Check it out. 3 straight hours of pregame, all the top 25 battles, all the selections on this video, along with some of the under-the-radar games as the week progresses. You could check me out Saturday, this Saturday from the Meadowlands, 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern. College football today. Stream it on Xumo, XUMO, channel 719. Channel 719, or go to sportsgrid.com. College football today, 3-hour pregame. We have you covered. Check it out, sportsgrid.com. Right into the selections for this coming Saturday. Going to be very SEC heavy. So let's start. It's going to be 4 games within the SEC, 2 in the Big Ten, and 1 independent. So let's jump right into it. Let's start with the big battle in Starkville. It's Alabama on the road to face Mississippi State. Alabama opened up as a 19-point favorite. It's already up to 21.5, and the reason why is a couple of factors. Obviously, Alabama's dominated the series since 2009. Alabama's won 10 straight over the Bulldogs. The last 4 meetings, they've won by an average margin of victory of 26 points per game. Look at this victory last year by Alabama. They won 24-0 as a 23.5-point favorite in Tuscaloosa. When you look at Alabama, what can you say? A dominating win by LSU last week, 45-41. Make no mistake about it. The score was not indicative of how dominating of a win that was for LSU up against Alabama's defense. LSU led by 20 at the half, but more importantly, Joe Burrow stepped up, 31 of 39 completions, 393 yards, 3 touchdowns, no interceptions. Clyde Edwards-Helaire and that offensive line of LSU wore down Alabama at the point of attack for 166 rushing yards. Now Alabama has no margin of error. They have to go on the road for an early kick to face a mediocre team in Mississippi State that is coming out of a bye week. Make no mistake about it as well. This is Mississippi State's bowl game. They're going to get and give Alabama their best shot this coming Saturday. Here's the thing that I look at. You look at Alabama, run support's a key concern for this defense overall. They're allowing 131 rushing yards per game, their highest effort in terms of run support since prior to 2009. You have a Mississippi State offense that's averaging 217 yards on the ground. The only way Mississippi State can win this matchup is if they run the football, take time off the clock, and keep Tua on the sidelines. I think they can do it. Secondly as well, what's the psyche of Alabama, especially getting hit in the mouth, and I mean dominated at home in Tuscaloosa? They gave up the most home points since 1957 in regulation, not overtime. Alabama allowed the most points at home in Bryant-Denny Stadium since 1957. So what is the psyche going up against a mediocre opponent coming out of a bye week? They could come out flat. They might make mistakes. This is still a young team, and I'm not sold with the consistency offensively and defensively of Nick Saban and the staff for this year. Forget years past. We're talking 2019 Alabama. Alabama wins this matchup, but Mississippi State does cover this 21.5-point number Saturday afternoon. Let's look at another big battle. It's Auburn and Georgia. Georgia's won 4 of the last 5 against the Tigers by an average margin of victory of 12.7 points per game. Picked up this victory last year, 27-10, and has been dominating the competition in recent weeks. They stepped up against Missouri without Kelly Bryant, won that battle convincingly last week at home as a 19.5-point favorite. Didn't run the football all that well, only rushed for 166 yards in the home win over Missouri. They now go on the road to face another team coming out of a bye week. Now, Auburn, 2 weeks ago, I was on Ole Miss. They were catching 19.5, 20. They covered that matchup and almost had an opportunity to win that ballgame within the last minute of the game. Auburn survived. They now come out of a bye week. I like the front 7 of Auburn in this matchup. Here's why. You look at Georgia, they're going to need to run the football against Auburn. I'm still not sold on this passing attack of Jake Fromm. I know they're averaging around 240 passing yards per game, but it's not the same offense as it was last year. Last week, they struggled in critical spots on third down. Jake Fromm made some inconsistent throws. He's going on the road. You're going to need to run the football more consistently. This is an Auburn defense that's still only allowing 112 rushing yards per game, holding opposing offenses in the area of about 38% on third down conversions over the last few weeks, 31% on the year. I think they could force Jake Fromm into critical long third down situations, make enough turnovers, they're +2 in turnover margin, and run the football. More importantly, I love the way DJ Williams has come on in recent weeks. Number three reminds me of Rusty Williams for Auburn back in the day of 1997 and 1998 with head coach Terry Bowden. But I think Auburn can run the football on Georgia's front seven. I think that's the recipe. Keep Jake Fromm on the sidelines, work off of play action with Bo Nix, even though Bo Nix is only completing 56% of his passes, 12 touchdowns, an extra week of preparation playing at home, I think will benefit him. Here's another cause of concern for Georgia. 9 games into the year, only 20 sacks. They're going to need a better effort. Even if they get by Auburn, if they make it to the SEC championship game, they need a better effort. I'm not sold on the front seven in terms of generating a pass rush. Give me Auburn in the upset. I think it's low scoring, 27-23. Well, maybe it's high scoring, 27-23. Auburn gets the victory over Georgia. I think it's a classic ball game, but Auburn does pull out a 4-point win over the Bulldogs this coming Saturday. Another big battle is the game prior in Columbia, Florida on the road against Missouri. Keep and monitor the health of Kelly Bryant. I still like Missouri here. I know I was on Missouri last week, but I didn't think they played all that bad on the road with Taylor Powell, especially from a defensive perspective. They held Georgia to 166 rushing yards in that matchup. But more importantly, Missouri's won 2 straight in the series. They knocked off Florida last year 38-17 the week after Georgia beat Florida in the cocktail party. It was homecoming as well. Now Florida goes on the road. This is a Florida team that has played well and dominated Vanderbilt at home. They ran the football, passed the football all over the Commodores. They now go on the road to face a very athletic secondary in Missouri. I think they match up very well against the Gators. I'm not sold on Florida's rushing attack. This is a Florida offense only averaging around 145 yards on the ground. And more importantly, I think Missouri's speed off the edge can put some pressure on Kyle Trask. Here's the matchup as well. Roundtree and Beatty, when you look at last year, Roundtree caught a lot of passes out of the backfield in the screen game to Drew Locke. Look for the same type of matchup in this matchup at home with Beatty. They utilized him in the second half in the screen game. I think they started a little too late in that ball game. Look for them to start the game to neutralize Florida's speed, run them sideline to sideline, and that can open up rushing lanes later against Florida's defense. If Kelly Bryant plays, I think it's a different offense, but even without him, I think Missouri strikes the upset over Florida this coming Saturday. Think it's in the area of about 28-24, same type of score, 28-24, Missouri gets the win over Florida this coming Saturday. Another big battle takes place in College Station. It's South Carolina on the road against Texas A&M. Texas A&M has dominated the series. They've won 5 straight over South Carolina by an average margin of victory of 10.4 points per game. They got this victory last year in South Carolina by 7 points. But keep an eye out for the South Carolina team. They're sitting at 4-6. I know they lost to Appalachian State last week by a 6-point favorite. They were in a position to win that matchup in the last minute. They threw a pass in the end zone, went incomplete, and they dropped that matchup 20-15. But this is still a solid defense for South Carolina. This is a defense over back-to-back weeks against Vanderbilt and App State. They allowed 113 rushing yards and 97 rushing yards, respectively, in those ballgames. Front seven is playing very well. Front seven is only allowing 3.8 yards per carry heading into this matchup against A&M, and I think that's a critical factor going on the road. Let me tell you why, because South Carolina's had and had the hardest SEC schedule out of any team. They were ranked first in terms of strength of schedule, 697 winning percentage of their 2019 opponents. For that front seven to still only be allowing 3.7, 3.8 yards per game at this point in the season means they're not wearing down at the point of attack. Going on the road up against a one-dimensional offense in Texas A&M and Kellen Mond, I think they can force them into long third downs. Now, they need to win out the last two games. They need to beat Texas A&M. They need to beat Clemson. So I expect South Carolina to give you their best effort on the road. Ryan Helinski has played adequately. He's completing around 59, 60% of his passes heading into this matchup. They still have Feaster at the running back position. They didn't get the rushing attack going last week against App State, but I look for them to work off a play action, challenge Texas A&M over the top to open up rushing lanes for Feaster and those running backs. Their defense will keep them in it. I'm calling for the upset. South Carolina over A&M, even though they lost five straight, look for the Gamecocks to rebound in a big way and get the road win over the Aggies, even though Texas A&M coming out of a bye week this coming Saturday. Two Big 12 games. We'll start with the big one in Waco. Oklahoma on the road as a 10.5-point favorite against Baylor. Oklahoma's won four straight by an average margin of victory of 18 points per game. Picked up this win last year, 66-33 against the Bears in Norman. Kyler Murray had a big day. The offense broke out for over 500 yards of total offense. And I think this is a bad matchup for Baylor. I've been all over the Bears. They were one of my surprise teams this year in my preview for the second straight year. I love Charlie Brewer. Love what Matt Rhule has done. They're undefeated. They got a gutty road win last week, 29-23 in three overtimes. They found a way to win, but I still think this is a bad matchup for their defense going up against Jalen Hurts. Now, Trey Sermon is hurt for Oklahoma. I understand that. They still have Kennedy Brooks. This is still an Oklahoma offense averaging 587 yards per game. They're averaging over 240 rushing yards per game, passing for over 300 with Hurts. But it really comes down to the mobility of Jalen Hurts in this matchup. I think he could put some pressure on Baylor, their front seven. That's only given up 3.3 rushing yards per game and only around 137 rushing yards to opposing offenses. But they haven't faced an athlete at the quarterback position like Jalen Hurts heading up into this point in the season. You go back to that Oklahoma State game, that road win that they won, they allowed 281 rushing yards to Chuba Hubbard and Spencer Sanders. I think that's the recipe for Oklahoma. Here's another factor as well. Not sold on the offensive line of Baylor that's allowed 24 sacks. I think that you see the same type of defensive game plan going up against Texas where they sacked Sam Ellinger nine times in that battle. Look for Alex Grinch to dial up a lot of blitz packages to force some pressure on that offensive line, much the way West Virginia did a few weeks ago. And I think that's the matchup for Oklahoma to win this ball game by 17 points or more. I think it's way too much speed offensively and defensively for the Sooners playing a prime time. They'll be up and into this matchup. Oklahoma wins five straight over Baylor and covers the number by 17 points or more Saturday night in Waco. The other big battle is TCU and Texas Tech. TCU lost that matchup to Baylor. They were in a position to win. The kid made an incredible touchdown catch, putting his hand down in the corner of the end zone. It looked like they would make enough plays, but Max Duggan, still inconsistent as a freshman. Here's a factor why I like Texas Tech. Let's just break down their offense with Jet Duffy. A big day last week on the road in West Virginia. He completed 24 of 34 passes, 354 passing yards. He made some plays with his legs, 34 rushing yards on the ground. And over the last three games, Iowa State, Kansas, West Virginia, he's played clean with the football. Five touchdown passes, no interceptions. And I think that's a critical factor going up against TCU. That's still -4 in turnover margin on the road heading into this matchup. Keep an eye out for this as well. Texas Tech has played very well in recent weeks. Back-to-back games now, they've held their opponents under 3.7 yards per carry rushing, under 150 yards rushing, which is a critical factor of the front seven heading into this matchup. Here's another factor as well. Let's just look at TCU. Everybody thinks TCU is an elite team in the Big 12. Since 2016, this team is 17-17 overall in Big 12 play. They're a 500 team. With a freshman quarterback going on the road, they haven't played well this year. Straight up, They're 1-3 straight up and against the number. The only road game that they've won was earlier in the year against Purdue, and we see how good Purdue is this year, struggling to become bowl eligible. More importantly, the three games that they lost on the road in conference, TCU's lost those games by an average margin of defeat of 13 points per game. TCU's 3-6 against the number. On the flip side, you have Texas Tech sitting at 5-3 against the number. I like Texas Tech. Lubbock is a very difficult place to play. They have the better defense heading into this matchup with the better quarterback in Jet Duffy. Texas Tech gets a 10-point win over TCU this coming Saturday. Here's the last pick of the day. It's an independent. I'm going against the numbers. I know I'm crazy, but I know Navy has played very well against Notre Dame. Notre Dame has won 4 straight in the series by an average margin of victory of 12.6 points per game. More importantly, Notre Dame is 0-3 against the midshipmen, against the number. Even though they won this matchup 44-22 last year, they did not cover the 23-point spread in San Diego last year. But here's why I like Notre Dame in this matchup. Now, Notre Dame, dominating road win over Duke. They laid 8 points in that matchup, 131-7. They rushed for 288 yards on that Duke front seven. And make no mistake about it, that was a solid Duke front defense that was only giving up 145 rushing yards per game. Duke only allowed Alabama week one to rush for 144 yards on the ground. So think about how dominant that effort was at home in Durham, where Notre Dame played last in Duke in 1961. So Duke was into that matchup. They gave it their best effort, and Notre Dame just absolutely thralled them in the rushing attack. I expect the same thing going up against Navy. I know Notre Dame has not played well at home this year, but I expect a better effort, laying less than 10 points. I think Notre Dame wins this ball game by 17 points or more. Navy coming out of a bye week, they're sitting at 7-1. Doesn't matter. Too much offensive line and defensive line play for Notre Dame. They do get a 17-point win over the midshipmen this coming Saturday. I'm just getting started. Follow the College Football Today show this Saturday, November 16th, 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern, College Football Today. See you this Saturday. And I just love talking about college football. It's awesome, man. See you this weekend. Good luck with the games.